You are not an ordinary person. We are the outshining of God's glory. Don't let any circumstance have enough power to bother you. The Father has nowhere to stay than inside you and cannot express himself unless through your body. So your body becomes his body. That is why the Bible says we are the body of Christ. Sound it. Say, I'm a doer of the word. I'm a world shaker. I live by the word. I'm born by the word. We are here to produce heaven on this earth. I produce heaven on earth. Zadiva Kasi. For whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory. That's why I say, don't give up. Hey! Moko sei ki para vuka du seti baha. Zagu, rebege de bezia. Vege, yakusa tifaros ki para kataya. Ah, I feel like turning water into one.
Pastor Brent, word hearing.
The display of our identity in Christ.
Part 2.
Sometimes when I hear certain things happening to certain Christians, I begin to wonder. What have they been hearing all this while? If it happens to you and you are in this state of life, what have you been hearing? You don't even have a notebook. Amen. You don't have a Bible. You don't have a notebook. You just came to church to look at us and go home. And on your way, the devil says, oh, this one is free. Let's go after him. They said, the man of God said, devils will not chase us, but now devils are chasing me. You called them. When you came to church with no Bible and with no book, and you just came to sit down and to go back, just to receive a prophecy and go home, you were calling the devils to follow you. And the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. That's Jesus. It says, and the word became flesh, and the word dwelt among us. It started from verse 1 when it talks about, in the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. So the word was in God from the beginning. Then it says, and the word became flesh. So the word of God took on flesh. So when Jesus was walking on this earth and they were calling him the Jesus of Nazareth, he was, yes, the Jesus of Nazareth, but he was the word of God that had become flesh, that had taken on flesh. So he had become God in flesh. God that had taken human form. Jesus was God that had taken human form. Is that not powerful? So he had taken human form. Then he says, go to verse 15. That's when he says the word became flesh, and he says, and the word dwelled among us. The word that had become flesh. God that had taken the form of man was coming. Inside was God in flesh, walking in the midst of men and touching them. Is that not powerful? He was so extraordinary that the people could not explain him. They said, by what wisdom do you do these things? One day, one of the high priests went to him at night. He went to him at night, Nicodemus. He said that we know that you are a teacher that comes from God. You are a what? A teacher that comes from God. For no man can do these mighty works, he says, except God be with him. Amen. The scripture says Jesus did so much signs and wonders to that point where even the books, if they were writing all the signs he did, the books would have been so full that the earth would not be able to contain the books. So the signs he did were plenty than the human beings on earth. You know what I just said?
Yes, Pastor.
So that if they were writing it in books upon books, then there would not be space here. Say powerful. But it was God that had taken flesh. It was God that was coming on this earth. And he came. Don't want to go into all of that. Is that not powerful? Go to verse 18. Is that not powerful? I'm trying to show you why Jesus said that. Amen. And how Jesus himself believes that we can do that. See, what God says you can do is what you can do. You hear what I just said? What God says you are is who you are. What God says you have is what you have. What God says you carry is what you carry. What God says you can do is what you can do. Is that powerful? It says, no man has seen God at any time. So it tells us that throughout in the Old Testament, no one ever saw God. No one in the Old Testament never saw, no one saw God. It says, no man has seen God at, this was John talking. No man has seen God at any time. Then it says, the only begotten Son, which is in the bosom of the Father, he has declared him. So when it says he was in the Father as the word of the Father. The Father, say the Father.
The Father.
Amen.
Amen.
Then he was born. And then he came on this earth. Born into the world. So when he was in the Father, he was in the Father as the Word. He had not yet appeared on stage. He was in the Father. Then the Father decided to bring himself out through his Word. And then he came out through his Word. Then we have Jesus walking. An extraordinary man. The scripture says that one day he was preaching. And there was a person with an unclean spirit. And the person with an unclean spirit started shouting. And saying, Jesus, have you come to destroy us before our time? The extraordinary man. The extraordinary Jesus. Say the extraordinary Jesus.
The extraordinary Jesus.
Full of God. Full of the Spirit. He was extraordinary from birth. His birth was extraordinary. He was born of God. So without the presence of the Holy Spirit, he was still extraordinary. He wasn't extraordinary because he had received the Holy Ghost. No. He was extraordinary because he was born of the Holy Spirit. When Mary asked, how shall this be? He says, the Spirit of God shall come upon you. And the power of the Highest shall overshadow you. So that the child that you shall give birth to shall be called the Son of the Highest. So the Holy Spirit gave birth to Jesus. How? Through the agency of the Word of God and the Holy Spirit. The Word was spoken by the angel. That is why when we speak words like this, you don't take it lightly. When we say this week nobody gets an accident, you don't take it lightly. Because the words that are coming, those words are the words of God. The angel carried the word. That is why I tell you, write it down, write it down. Write all the things I'm saying, they are all spirits and they are things. Amen. Amen. The word of God. The angel carried the word like this. Took the word to Mary. Mary received the word. Then the Spirit of the Lord, the Holy Ghost, came upon that word and brought a baby out. Is that not powerful? Is that not powerful? Is that not powerful? So Jesus was not an ordinary person even from birth. He was not ordinary. Until he was just moving around, relaxing with his, all the extraordinary things in life. Because you see, he had the life of God from birth. Zoe, eternal life. He had the nature of God from birth, the righteousness of God. Amen.
Amen.
But they were all in his spirit as even as a baby. Then he grew to age 12 when he displayed some kind of prowess. I said, oh, okay, this guy is powerful. Let us watch what he will become. Amen.
Amen.
Then age 30 when the Holy Spirit came and remained in him. Is that powerful? So from birth, he was extraordinary. That was Jesus. And he did not just say, I am extraordinary. I am extraordinary. He displayed it. So when the Holy Ghost came to cause him to be able to display who he was. Do you hear what I just said? So at age 30, when the Holy Spirit came, he went to be baptized, and the heavens were opened, and the Spirit descended like a dove. and went inside of him like this. From that time, from age 30, he started displaying his identity. He was extraordinary, but he could not display it until the Holy Ghost came inside. So the coming of the Holy Ghost, even in Jesus, was not only to minister to Jesus, but to also minister through Jesus, to enable Jesus to display to the world that he was not ordinary. Did you hear what I just said? Yeah. You heard just knock somebody. Are you listening to Pastor or you are feeling hot? Is that powerful?
It's powerful.
Are you following what I'm saying? So Jesus as a child was not, I'm trying to establish a point here, was not ordinary. He was not ordinary because he was born like that. See, when he was even born, he was living with Joseph. He was living with who? He was helping his father do some kind of carpentry works. He was actually even born in a manger. That means that it wasn't where he was born that determined who he was. It was who gave birth to him. Do you hear what I just said? Because he was born in a manger. So he could have said, oh, as for me, I live in a kiosk. I am ordinary. I live in a kiosk. As for me, I live in on the streets. I am ordinary. I live on the streets. But he was born in a manger. He was helping his father do carpentry work like you help your parents do plumbing works and all of those. He was helping. But even though he was helping Joseph, he was still not ordinary. That's what I'm trying to say. So it is not where you are or where you live that shows that you are extraordinary or you are ordinary. No. It is who has given birth to you. Amen. So when the Holy Ghost came inside, the Holy Ghost came to help him and to cause him to do what we call extraordinary works. That is to display who he was. Then he started doing things. You will do things from today.
Amen.
I say you will do things from today.
Amen.
I say you will do things from today.
Amen.
Is that powerful? So the scripture says that if you have seen Jesus, you have seen the Father. Actually, when the Holy Ghost came, that was the fullness of God that had come to reside in Jesus. Is that not powerful?
Powerful.
Let me just end with Jesus. Say, end with the Jesus and come to us. Now go to John chapter, the same one, verse 14, verse 12, I think verse 12. I'm just trying to give you some gist of Jesus. Is that not powerful? Go to verse 11, let me see. Malandos Atalabahaya. He says, he's talking about Jesus. Jesus came unto his own. He says, and his own received him not. He came unto his own. And his own received him not. He says, but as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. Is that not powerful? So we've talked about Jesus. Did we talk about Jesus? Then he says, Jesus came unto his own, and his own believed him not. Then he says, but as many as received him, to them he gave the power to become the sons of God. So if you have believed in Jesus, you've been given what we call the power of authority. To become. To be what?
Become.
Not on the way becoming. You have become.
Become.
It is to become the sons of God. Even to them that believe on his name. So if you believe on his name, you have received Christ. It means that you have become. So you were at first the boy who was born in Choco, walking around. Your fathers, your parents will call you Kofi, then you come. Kwabena, then you come. When you believed in Jesus, there was a change.
Hallelujah. Yeah.
Stay tuned.
Your ever-inspiring question and answer segment, Ask Pastor Prince, is back on your screens.
You're answering a question from Naomi. She says, hello, Pastor Prince. I'm Naomi. I've been immensely encouraged by your teachings on YouTube. Thank you for your efforts. Thank you very much, Naomi. Why will a God of love, who loves us so much and even sinners, consider taking many people to hell, all because they don't believe in him? Does he love and hate?
Ask Pastor Prince shows every Wednesday, 7 o'clock p.m. on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube.
Send all your questions to the comment section on our Facebook, Instagram, or YouTube pages. You can also send us questions on WhatsApp.
+233 20 921 6523. You are blessed.
Have changed.
Yes.
See, the change you are looking for is already within.
Hallelujah.
When there's a change outside, it's just a manifestation of the change within. It is not strange to God that you hold millions of dollars. It is not strange to God that you get a job at the bank. It is rather strange when you don't have one. You hear what I just said? It is rather strange when you don't do what? Have one. It is not strange to God that you lay hands on the sick and they recover. It is not strange. The things we see and we call testimonies to God, it is our normal life that we are supposed to be living as Christians. Because as many as believed him, to them, he gave them power. It's not a power that he's giving like he's transferring power, no. It's a delegated authority. Giving somebody the privilege to be part of you. Like you're in the home and a person comes. Begging for bread, say, come and live in my house from today. You belong to me. I'm eating at my table with you. So it's a power of attorney. It's a power, a delegated authority to become. So he did not just give us power. You see, when he don't just allow us to become or allow us to just, like, I come to your house, I'm begging, I knock the door, you say, come. Now we sit at the table. That's first level. That is the power. Then to become means that there was a making. There was what?
A making.
That's what we call being born again. The scriptures say being born again, not of corruptible seed, but of an incorruptible seed. So when you say, I am born again, you have become. You have been created in your spirit. The one who enters the church to be born again, if he was dark, he's still dark. If he was fat, he's still fat. But what has taken place? That experience has taken place on the inside, in your spirit, in your inward man. So there is a change that has taken place within you. And that change makes you an extraordinary person. So it says that to become the sons of God. When it says the sons of God, it's talking about somebody who is identified with God. Somebody who came out of God. Somebody that God has given birth to. So you are here. You are here. You may be sleeping on the streets, but God has given birth to you. Yeah. You may be sitting in an air conditioner in your office, counting the money of other people, but God has given birth to you.
Yeah.
You are not great because of where you work. You are not great because of what you do. You are not great because of where you come from or where you sleep in the natural. You are great because of who you are. You are. Say, I am. So from your spirit, there have been a change. And it's important you identify or you understand this change. I have become a child of God. I have become a son of God. I used to just be a son of man walking around. But there has been a change in my spirit. And because of that, you have received what we call eternal life in your spirit. You have received what we call the righteousness of God in your spirit. So you are not ordinary.
I am not ordinary.
You are not a victim in this life. Do you hear what I just said? You have the ability to do extraordinary things by your identity. Do you hear what I just said?
Yes.
Have you heard what I just said right now? Is that not powerful?
Powerful.
Lift
up your hand and say, I am not ordinary.
I am not ordinary.
I used to think I was ordinary.
I used to think
David was more powerful than myself.
I
used to think Solomon was more wiser than me.
I
used to think Samson was more stronger than myself. But I have changed. From today, I have come to know I'm not ordinary. You see, all those Samsons and Josephs and the Solomons we are talking about, they were looking forward to us. Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Esau, who else? All the people we whose names we mention in the Old Testament, they were looking forward. They were looking. Even though they were working with the Lord, they were looking. They were expecting us. They did not know what time we would arrive. Is that not powerful?
Oh.
They were expecting Jesus. But they did not know when Jesus will come. But they were looking. When would this happen? I can see a change somewhere. I see somebody in the system, different person. They were looking. Is that not powerful?
Powerful.
Then Jesus came. After Jesus came and he was going, he brought us out from within.
Mm-hmm.
By his resurrection. It says, anyone that believes in me has become like me. Go to Hebrews chapter 2. Let me shock you there. Say, shock us. So I want you to understand that as you are sitting down here, let's just put the Holy Ghost aside. I'm not talking about the Holy Ghost. I'm talking about you yourself. You, without the Holy Spirit, you are extraordinary. Is that not powerful?
It's powerful.
Oh, Mada Asute Ekolobo Saya. Hebrews chapter 2. Oh, Tabasata. Hebrews chapter 2, verse 5 to 11. Is that not powerful? Is that not powerful?
It's powerful.
Verse what? 5 to 11. Are we there?
Yes.
For unto the angels has he not put in subjection the world to come, whereof we speak. Verse 6. But one in a certain place testified, saying, what is man that thou art mindful of him, or the son of man that thou visitest him? Is that not powerful?
Are
you hearing something?
Yes, Pastor.
I'm not ordinary.
I am not ordinary.
Some of you think that you must do dubious things to survive because of the economy. It's a wrong understanding of yourself. Some of you think I must steal something before I can survive. You say, oh, you know why I'm not surviving? Because I have not started stealing. You know why I'm not surviving? Because the economy is bad. You know why I'm not surviving? Because there's this and that and that. Kalaboso tolobosa. It is because of your upbringing. You hear what I just said? I've said it before. I said you must be determined for a change to see a change. And I'm not talking a change within, I'm talking a change without. Amen.
Amen.
The man said, Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. The people said, keep quiet. He said, no, leave me. Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. The people said, keep quiet. You are making noise. He said, leave me. I want a change. He said, Jesus. The first time he said it, Jesus heard it. Jesus was going. He said the second time, Jesus heard it, Jesus was going. The third time, Jesus turned and said, where is that young man mentioning my name here and there? Bring him up. Determination. The woman with the issue of blood said, if I may touch the hem of his garment within her. She said it within her spirit. And when she said it, she did not sit down. Well, we'll get a baby in this church. You are sitting in the house. We call, when are you coming to church? It's 11 o'clock. Say, I'm looking for a foot of the womb. You are not serious. See, he said, if I touch the hem of his garment, I'll be what? And the multitudes were all about around Jesus. But she still found herself. She found a way through the multitudes. She did not need Jesus to touch. She just held the hem of Jesus' garment like this. getting seized. The woman has been suffering for years. For many years. Over 10 years of suffering in one condition. And she wanted a change. And she has seen Jesus, the world changer. And Jesus was passing by. And he saw. She saw. She said, no. When Jesus said, somebody has touched me. The disciple said that Peter said, Jesus, look at this multitude. Everybody is touching you here and there. Kalabasata. That is what differentiates between those who receive in the house of God and those who become great in the house of God and those who stay and not receive. Because multitudes were about Jesus, walking with him. Some were touching him. Some were even pushing him. The macho men were like, don't touch him, don't touch him. Multitudes. But then Jesus said, someone has touched me. Peter said, Master, all these people are around you. They are touching you. What kind of touch? This was a touch of faith. A touch of determination to see change. I cannot stay like this forever. Is that powerful? The woman said, I'm the one who touched you, Master. I know Peter was surprised because we are all touching him. How come you've not seen anything? Malando Skolobo Sotoya. Is that not powerful? We are all shaking his hands. We have not seen anything. But there was a shaking of hands of faith. You see, there are a lot of gymnastics in the system. Do this, do that, bring that. Sometimes, what is all this? What is what? All this. It's because of ignorance. Somebody wanted to see Jesus. I'm trying to tell you something. All the Old Testament folks got wanted to see Jesus in one way or the other. Even Abraham. Even Adam from the beginning. Adam. Adam himself wanted to see the second Adam. Isn't that powerful? He was looking. Who is the second Adam coming? But he was too far from the second Adam. Then all those people in the days of Jesus. Elijah and Elisha. So those of you who believe that we are in the days of Elijah and singing those songs, stop it. Amen. They were looking forward to this Jesus. These people were around him. But the woman took a step of faith and touched Jesus. Is that not powerful? He was not ordinary. He was not what? You see? But you see, we are not those people who were looking for Jesus to touch. We are not. We are not those people who are calling Jesus. I am blind, Jesus. I'm Maladoska. We are the ones who have been associated, made Jesus. See, when you sitting down here like this, some of you own powerful businesses. Some of you have started owning powerful businesses. Because it says that, what did I say? We are not those ones just looking for Jesus to solve our problems. That is the 1% level of the church. Jesus must solve our problems. Oh, Jesus, when will you hear me? Why has Jesus delayed like that? Kalandos Okoya, as you are saying, he's sitting down like this, looking at your face. You are not ordinary. We are the ones who have been identified with Jesus by birth. We are the ones that when you put this young man here, stand there. Come, Pastor Obed. When you put this young man to here, if this is Jesus, if Obed believes in Jesus by birth, Obed has become just like this one. The Christian is the Christ type. That's why we say we are Christians. We are not the ones who are going to Jesus to do. We are the ones who have believed in him, become like him, or we have been made, like I said, for as many as believe, he has given us power to become. So every day when you see me pray and fast, it is just distribution I'm after. There are dimensions of distribution. It is just to display who I am. Have you seen those magicians who come on TV and they be displaying certain things? So they are not two different. They are not different. Two of them are not different. The only difference is that this one is the Lord of this one. This is his master. Because it is through this one that he became like him. So he is the boss. Is he the boss?
Yes.
You can sit down. Is that not powerful?
Watch Pastor Prince on Precious TV every Saturday morning, 9 o'clock a.m. Also on YouTube at Christ World Television. You are blessed. For our Sunday services, every Sunday morning, 9:30 a.m. at Airport West Hotel, Accra. You are blessed.